You have heard about Milton Friedman, the famous management guru. In 1970, he said, the business of business is business. You have to do it in the right way, in a polite way, you have to respect the rule of law, etc., but that's it. And today we have Michael Porter, also a management guru from Harvard Business School, and he says, no, it's about creating shared value. A company is there to generate economic value, but at the same moment, you have to generate social value by addressing the needs of society. That's one element, creating shared value. The second one is about the idea to have new alliances. I already said something about it. Companies cannot act alone. If you want to act, you need others. Let me give an example, Unilever. Well, you all know Unilever. I think it's a very interesting company. They've integrated sustainability into their business model. They have a strategy that's called Sustainable Living Plan. When they had their first year evaluation, that was not an internal Unilever event, no. It was an event with all the partners in the value chain, but also other companies were invited, NGOs were invited, government officials, and people from the academic world. Choose for a stakeholder approach. So we will see more and more new alliances. You cannot act alone, you need to work together with others. That's essential. And the third point is, have more focus on the long term. We've seen in 2008 what the consequences can be of short-term focus on making profit. What we've seen in the financial crisis is we had all kinds of stimuli, bonus systems, all kinds of facilities in order to be very successful in the short run. And if you fail with having a long-term focus, then you get difficulties. And now more and more people are saying, take into account the issue of the long-term. When I was in Japan, I spoke with a lot of companies over there, and what kept me busy is that they were talking about what are the values of our corporation. And many companies use sustainability as a value. And then I asked, why do you have these values? Well, that has to do with, let's say, the family character of many businesses. You can see it over there. I think the issue of value is very important. And of course, you can say to me, well, Jan Pieter, but the discussion about CSR is there for decades. Yeah, that's true. The discussion about CSR has been there for decades, but something has changed. First thing is the discussion about growth. In the 70s, we had a Club of Rome, and the message was limits to growth. I think today we say growth is part of human nature. A sportsman wants to reach the gold medal at the Olympic Games. A researcher wants to realize the best research results. An entrepreneur wants to discover new markets. So growth is a part of human nature, but not at all costs. So it must be sustainable growth. Let me give an example. Ray Anderson, he was the founder of a carpet industry in the United States. He started in the 70s, he was very successful. Every year the turnover was higher. Profits increased. And after 20 years, he received an invitation to give a speech about his economic success. And that was the moment when he started reflecting. He said, okay, it's true, my profits went up all the time. I'm very successful. But have I ever asked myself how I've reached those profits? Have I been thinking about my CO2 emissions? Have I been thinking about energy efficiency or probably even the renewables? What about labor conditions for people in the third world? What about the fair treatment of my workers? All these issues. And that was the moment when he said we have to integrate all these components in our business model and our business strategy. That's what you can see. When I started working at EY, people said, oh, that's nice, you've been prime minister, what you're doing now? I said, I'm partner at EY. Oh, what are you doing? I'm partner corporate responsibility. And the Americans said, ah, that's great. We do a lot in the sphere of corporate responsibility. And my question was, what are you doing? And the answer was, we give money to charity. And of course, there's nothing wrong with giving money to charity, to cancer research, hospitals, museums. But the fundamental question is, how have you reached your profits? That's the issue. So the issue of growth has changed. When we talk about sustainability, the question is how can it influence, how can it change your business model and your business strategy? Are you integrating those components in your business model? The third one is the business case. There has been a time the attention for sustainability increased when the economy went up, and when there was an economic slowdown, the attention faded away. That was a traditional situation. And now more and more you can see the opposite. It is possible to be profitable by choosing for sustainability. First, Eccles of Harvard Business School, he made a comparison between 90 what he called high sustainability companies and 90 low sustainability companies, between 1993 and 2010. And the outcome was that the high sustainability companies had a higher rate on return on investment, a better position on the stock market, and better reputation than the low sustainability ones. It's very interesting. And there is enough proof that it is possible to change things if you have the willingness to rethink your business model. It is possible. And the last component is, if you say we choose for sustainability, it must be an honest story, and that's about measurement and reporting. I'm working in the world of auditors. The auditors will have another task and responsibility in the future. Now it's about delivering assurance on the financial performance of a company. In the future, it will be about integrated reporting. It's not only about the financial performance, but also about the socio-ecological performance of a company and the integration of both of them. That means also an accountant, an auditor, needs a more holistic approach. That's what you can see.